According to the American Diabetes Association, 16% of the almost 15 million people diagnosed with diabetes need daily doses of insulin. That used to mean a series of daily shots, but now some patients have an inhalable option to make the process a little easier. So why aren't more diabetics breathing in the concept? Dr. Mike is here now with tonight's health report.
Well, Kathy, for many diabetics, insulin injections can be painful and annoying, but a pain-free answer came last year in the form of Exubra, the first inhalable insulin. In spite of the fanfare surrounding the drug, though, for the most part, it's been a marketing flop, and experts say that is a shame.
60-year-old Sharon Sachs was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes 7 years ago and must take insulin before every meal to keep her blood sugar in check.
Sometimes it's a pain in the neck.
But now she says she has one less pain when it comes to getting her insulin. No needles necessary. She just puts it in. It's called Exubra, approved by the FDA last year, as the first diabetes treatment you inhale.
It's very fast. It's very efficient. And you can do it anywhere, take it with you anywhere. You know, so it just fits into your lifestyle very easily.
Someone who really does not want to take an injection may decide that this is something that feels more comfortable to them.
Despite that convenience, Exubra isn't taking off for many reasons. For one, many doctors don't perform the in-office breathing test that's required before the person can be put on Exubra.
Going to the endocrinologist first might have been a mistake, and particularly because we don't have spirometers in our office. We can't do the pulmonary function test.
Another issue, smokers and people with chronic lung disease like asthma can't use Exubra. Also, the device looks like a large bong to some. Some say it's really difficult to carry around. Insurance coverage is also an issue because Exubra is more expensive than traditional insulin. And simply getting the word out about inhaled insulin has been an issue. There's been no significant direct-to-consumer marketing yet.
Anything that's going to get the patient on insulin and improve their glycemic control is going to benefit the patient.
Seely says the patient training process can be cumbersome for some, and that can be a disincentive.
If it's going to be 3 or 4 visits, the patient's going to lose steam and maybe not come back. I think that's the problem, is we haven't ironed out how to do it right.
As a result, this weapon against diabetes is gathering dust.
If I could get someone to take that leap forward and actually go on insulin by using this, it's a win-win.
According to Brand Week, more than one analyst report says that less than 1,000 prescriptions were written per week total for Exubra. That is paltry. It's reported that Pfizer plans a major consumer marketing campaign in the second half of this year. For more information on this and other health stories, go to CW11.com/Dr. Mike.
And Dr. Mike, we know that there are two types of diabetes,
right?
Type 1 and type 2. Does this work for both?
That's the great thing about this. It's for both. Now, type 1 is the insulin-dependent diabetics. They have to have insulin. They have to have at least one long-acting shot of insulin a day, but it cuts down to the number of shots. I really like this for the type 2 diabetics who still produce some insulin. They may be on pills, they may be on some insulin, or a combination of both. This can get rid of the shots. They can use it with their pills, or they can just use it alone. But it can absolutely cut down on the number of shots, even in type 1 diabetics.
Maybe the word will get out soon.
We'll see.
It's kind of big, hard to carry around, but it'd be better than
huge.
A shot, I would think.
But as you pointed out, some diabetics would just be reticent to use it. Why change what they're doing if it's working?
Used to taking insulin in a shot.
Right.
Mike, thank you very much.